Of course, Larry, recently in Japan, a tournament was held to unify junior heavyweight and light heavyweight championships from around the world. In WCW, we refer to them as the Cruiserweight division. There were 8 titles from Japan, Mexico, and England all at stake. And recently, the Ultimo Dragon captured those 8 belts. His goal, to add the WCW Cruiserweight title, gain control of all the Cruiserweight championships in the world.
Well, unfortunately, his obstacle is Dean Malenko, a man who is very familiar with the Japanese style of wrestling. It's going to be a good one, Mike.
Certainly is, and of course, both of these men upcoming at World War III, Larry, in addition to singles competition, they as well will be involved in that 60-man three-ring battle royal. Of course, our broadcast partner, Bobby Heenan, is under the impression that Dean Malenko is actually the man that he's picking to win that battle royal. I'm not sure if he has the size, obviously, has the wrestling ability, but will all that mat technique really pay off in a match like this battle royal?
Well, they don't call Bobby the Brain for nothing, but he's thinking of a different light here. Don't count the little man out of a situation like this, because number one, the biggest of all men usually become the first target. The majority of guys inside that ring sometimes stick together. They want to eliminate the biggest and the baddest first. A guy like Rey Mysterio Jr., who is small but very fast, may have one of the best chances of surviving just with his movement alone.
And Dean Malenko, the WCW World Cruiserweight Championship, on his way to the ring. Of course, that title he recently regained in Las Vegas, Nevada at Halloween Havoc when he defeated Rey Mysterio Jr., ending Rey Jr.'s 4-month title reign. Of course, Rey Mysterio Jr. deeply disappointed when he lost that World's Cruiserweight title, but he's obviously focused on not only regaining that, but possibly those other 8 championship belts.
Boy, look at that pile of belts.
And now let's hear some comments from Rey Mysterio Jr.
Dean Malenko, I gotta be really honest with you. You gave me a chance for the Cruiserweight title, and I took it away. I gave you a chance, and you took it away from me. You know what? You're one of the toughest opponents I've ever had. But I want to meet with you again. I want to take that belt back and have it around my waist.
Rey Mysterio Jr., a man who obviously has his sights set on not only Dean Malenko, but of course also Ultimo Dragon, and upcoming at World War III, Dean Malenko scheduled to defend the Cruiserweight title against Psychosis. And we can tell you that Rey Mysterio Jr. will face Ultimo Dragon as well this Sunday in Norfolk, Virginia.
Oh, right there, Malenko got caught on the mat off guard, and that's not an easy thing to do with Dean. This guy is a master of mat technique. But again, he's very familiar, spent a lot of time over in Japan, so should be able to handle himself well. Knows how he blocks the pressure by putting the other foot up.
Of course, should Ultimo Dragon win the Cruiserweight Championship, he would face Psychosis upcoming this Sunday live on pay-per-view at World War III.
Every time you say World War III, Mike, it gives me goosebumps. Someone is going to get the opportunity. I almost wish it was me to break the foundation of the New World Order. Hulk Hogan must be beat for the heavyweight championship. The New World Order has gone too far already.
Of course, the New World Order, an attempted takeover on Saturday at the Cable Ace Awards, obviously upset that they were unsuccessful out in Hollywood. And tonight they came and brought chairs with them to the ring. And the Nasty Boys, as well as the tag team of High Voltage and Ciclope and Galaxy from Mexico, felt the wrath of the steel chairs from the Outsiders Hall in Nash.
It's getting way out of hand here, where announcers are walking off live television broadcast. They're taking advantage of it, but they have a plan to have leadership. Hogan must be defeated. The winner of World War III has an opportunity of a lifetime, and they better succeed at it.
And of course, last week on Monday Nitro, the New World Order demanding their own hour right here on TNT, the hottest program on television.
Well, that's just too bad, isn't it? Don't give it to them.
Recovery here by Malenko in a 2 count.
Whoa!
Reversal by Dragon. Of course, remember, waist lock by Malenko, standing switch. Remember, Larry, that back at the War Games, Eric Bischoff agreed to give the NWO their own television show, and now they're demanding a shot at Nitro. I hate to question Eric Bischoff, but why would he agree to stipulations like that?
I don't know. I just don't like what's going on. This is too ridiculous.
Oh, Dragon with that jump back kick, almost a leg lariat. Takes Malenko down to the floor, slides through, baseball slider check. Malenko catches him on the floor. And the reversal. Dragon sent him crashing into the steel guardrail.
Yeah, Malenko got it right against the rail. The Ultimate Dragon, smart man, threw him back in the ring. He's going up, but Malenko's on his feet.
Malenko follows Dragon to the corner. Dragon perched up on the top rope. Caught him with a back elbow. Succession of elbows takes Malenko down to the mat. Where does Dragon go from here? Moonsault attempt does not connect. Malenko able to roll out of the way.
Again, I told you, Malenko's very familiar with the Japanese style. He was almost waiting for it. He's got the Dragon on his back.
Again,
I don't know what he's going for here. He's taking too long.
Texas Cloverleaf is what he's trying to get cinched in if he can turn him over. He's got to make that long step. Sonny Ono up on the ring ropes. Malenko down. Oh, back body drops Sonny Ono into the ring. Back body drop for Dragon, and he goes all the way outside to the floor. Referee Randy Anderson calls for the bell.
That's going to be a disqualification. That went over the top.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match via an over-the-top rope disqualification, Ultimo Dragon!
Well, of course, as a result, Dean Malenko retains the Cruiserweight title, on to face Psychosis.